She says, Les, I'm not going to stand here late. I'm just going to read this.
But she did stand late. Chiquita's husband, Greg, told police his wife called him around 7 or so.
He's too fast.
Bring her something to eat. So he set out from their home in Baker about 25
minutes. That'll get.
And he said he went to McDonald's in Baker and got some hamburgers and fries and brought it to Chiquita in her office. Chiquita met him downstairs, according to Greg, and led him to the building because at 5:30 in the evening up to 7:30 the next morning, the building was locked. And unless you have a swipe card, you can't get access.
Brent told the cops he encountered a number of tenants in the building working late. He remembered running downstairs on a small errand for his wife.
Chiquita had a client that was coming over to pick up some money, so he went downstairs to pay this client and pick up some paperwork from his person for Chiquita.
Brent said Chiquita had more work to do and yet another client to see. So he said he took off for home sometime around 8:30. What happened next was a bloody mystery. It would be up to the detectives and also Frank Burns to figure out. The attorney, hearing the awful news on her car radio that morning, the one who got such a kick out of Chiquita before, was in fact a legendary Baton Rouge prosecutor.
My boss, the district attorney, was out there. There were so many police officers there. The crime scene van was there. And so I went into that and immediately said to my boss, I want this case.
Friend insisted, as she always does, on viewing the crime scene. As she entered the office, she noticed Chiquita had put some things up.
But then when we proceeded into the next room where her body was, I was like, oh my lord. She was butchered. She was laying on the floor. She had little slipper socks on her feet. The way all of us would be if we stay after work, you know, we keep our heels on. She basically had a law book that I think she had been reading that was in her hands at the time the attack began.
Chiquita had been stabbed 43 times. The attack was brutal and messy. The bloodstained wall suggesting a fight to the death.
Did you have another one?
No,
sir. Did you get lucky with a footprint or a partial print or anything in blood?
No, we did not get no lucky with a footprint.
No blood.
The killer had improbably vanished without leaving a trail. And at first glance, hadn't taken anything either.
Had the office been trashed? Had anybody been looking through files or something like that?
No, we didn't see that.
She had expensive jewelry still on her hand. She had earrings in her ear. So
this is starting to tell you some stuff about the nature of this killer.
That's correct.
It didn't look like a robbery. However, as crime scene techs processed the scene, the investigators realized Chiquita's wallet was missing from her purse. And there, in the victim's hand, what looked like a major clue.
And her left hand was open. There was a piece of hair in it. Not actually 91 strands of hair.
You idiot.
Over her head, and she just died like that.
Had she pulled it from her killer's head? The hair was gone. Had the killer been a woman? What were you thinking? What do you think of that?